while we move into our time of prayer. And we do need that, the God of grace and the God of mercy. Just a few moments ago, we received word, and we're helping as we can, that Lois Ellis does not feel well at all. And so we're reaching out to the family. So please be in prayer for Lois. We also heard this morning, Bill Wolf is not feeling well this morning. So please be in prayer for him. And Alice, of course, we want to continue to pray for Alice and for Bill. Janet, Major Janet Rowland is making progress. Are you? Yes, she's here. She's making progress. So we just praise God for healing there, as well as Tracy. So see, we've got two here. I hear you're making progress. We got your note that's better every day, and you're making progress. We're so glad about that. Major Marcia Cocker will be facing surgery on the 8th of October. Please remember her. And Colonel Marion Faulkner didn't have a good night last night, so she's resting this morning, and that's where Colonel Don is as well. So just remember Marion as her femur heals, and as they make plans to make that transition to Lakeland. Commissioner James Osborne had medical personnel called this morning, but it was his blood pressure, so he is home. Colonel Canning, blood sugar, I'm sorry, blood sugar. So it's sort of settled and he's at home, right? So so just remember him. Major Connie DeMichael just went to the emergency room this morning with an issue with a shoulder. So please remember her. We do need God's grace and his mercy for ourselves and also for our friends that we mentioned. We did hear about quite a few just this morning, so if there's someone I've forgotten, have I forgotten anyone that, okay, I'm going to make sure I covered that. We're going to sing together all our anxiety, all our care. We're going to bring it to God. We're going to leave it there. So our love for our friends, we're going to extend that love to them, but we're going to bring their needs to the Lord. There's never a burden he can't bear. True. Never a friend like Jesus. So let's sing that through a couple of times.
Thank you.
Father, you know if there is a heart here this morning or bound by sorrow. You know if there is a life weighed down with care. And we thank you that the invitation is always there to come. Come to the cross, come to your heart. Your arms are never folded across your chest as you look at us, but they are wide open and you are running towards us. And so if we have any anxiety, any care, we bring it to you. Because although we have friends, there's no friend closer than you. There's no friend so quick to hear but you. And so we bring to you our needs. We bring to you what's heavy on our heart, as well as the joys upon our hearts. Those that are already on our list, those that we heard about this morning, they're our friends. You created us to be in relationship with people. And when we're in relationship with people, so many times those friendships go deep. And so our dear friends, some of them who've had maybe just a bit of a scare this morning, but everything is okay. Those that continue to heal from surgeries and other procedures. We ask ongoing healing. We pray for Lois this morning, and we ask that you will bring about speedy and quick communication between her and her family. Father, how deeply you love. How deeply you care. We can try to imagine the depth of your love and how your love encompasses us. And that's good. But we can't even touch the depths, I think, of your love and your care and your concern. So when you say, bring anything on your heart to me, we know you mean it. And we know that you have our very best in mind. So all that is on our hearts, things that we've mentioned, the sorrows, the joys, the uncertainties, those things in our hearts that there's no way at this point in time that we can share out loud. You know those as well. And Father, we do ask in Jean's family that the baby will come safely and that the mom will be safe as they bring this incredible miracle into the world. As much as they will love that newborn child, your love for each of us goes far beyond even that, a human love, because it's a supernatural love you have for us. And it is in the lovely name of Jesus we pray. Amen.